Just remind me what problems you had.
Yeah, I think it was very masked, you know, very silent, word I've used quite a bit, whereby I've never had heartburn in my life, ever. I don't ever remember getting that thing that millions of people get. I don't remember being, you know, bringing up food or anything like that, or any discomfort, not even any, you know, the burning in the chest. But I'm a professional singer, and I have done that for 35 years, and people take the mickey out of me on the circuit, because when all the other guys are backstage going, me, 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 I have a Jack Daniels, you know. So I've got away very, very lucky to be able to be a rock singer for 35 years. And I just woke up one morning and literally, I knew immediately there was a tightness here. And it was do, re, mi, fa, sol, you know, and I was petrified.
So your problems were really with your voice, but you did have some other throat symptoms as well, I think, didn't you?
Yeah, I mean, there was you know, a soreness and also as some kind of, you know, bringing up some mucus, if you like, throat clearing, yeah. A lot of that, which is an odd one, isn't it? Because it's something you don't notice you're doing it until somebody says, stop doing that. Yeah. But if the point I make is mostly invisible, yeah. You know, for me.
Yeah. So obviously as a singer, this was a real problem. And I guess you immediately went to seek some help. What happened there?
Yeah. So the world of rock and roll is quite small, you know, so suddenly word got round. One name was a very, very senior guy at Harley Street. He was ENT, and he had a camera that he put down here and filmed it and could see the vocal cords spasming, especially on one side, but was puzzled as to why. Then he didn't really get very far, so he put me onto a very, very eminent voice coach, who gave me a little bag of goodies, which was a kazoo. So we had to sing through a kazoo, did nothing. And I was getting really desperate, you know, because this is now 4 or 5 months into not having been able to sing a note.
Okay. So you'd tried various treatments specifically aimed at your throat, but a clear diagnosis of what the underlying problem was had still yet to be reached. So you went back to your GP, and I think your GP thought, well, maybe this could be reflux related. Maybe this is this thing that people talk about, silent reflux, laryngopharyngeal reflux.
Yes, absolutely.
So he then sent you to see a gastroenterologist.
Yep.
So he put the camera down and examined the esophagus and the stomach and found essentially everything looked normal.
Yeah, again, normal.
And then you had the tube down the nose, the impedance reflux study, where you have a tube down the nose 24 hours, and that was negative. It was a bit borderline, but it didn't show definite evidence of reflux. So he reached the conclusion that you may have reflux, but he'd not proven it.
Yeah.
So what did he then do?
You know, he was the most disappointed of all of us, you know, because he said, come in, Nick. He said, I wish I could find something, you know. And that was always the thing. Everybody was saying, we wish we could tell you that we, you know, and God forbid, nobody ever found any of the classic stuff that singers get, you know, which is nodules and polyps or, God forbid, you know, cancer. So it was a kind of a weird journey where, you know, you'd phone your mum and go, they still haven't found anything, you know, but of course she's going, thank goodness, you know, so it was a very weird dichotomy. So he said, there's this bloke. And it really was like that. And he said, it's not far from you. He's in Sussex, Kent, which is where I live. And, you know, you can't make that up, because if ever you find a very, very specialised expert, I'd fly to Brussels to make it happen. But you happen to live 10 miles up the road. And that was where you came into the picture. And he said he's quite pioneering. He's got a whole organization that he's put together that specializes on various oddball, hidden types of reflux. And at this stage, you know, I was like, yeah, you know, I wasn't excited or anything or much impressed, really. I just was very down at that point. So I said, yeah, let's go meet him.
If I remember rightly, I said, well, the problem with laryngopharyngeal reflux is it can be a very difficult thing to establish for sure that if reflux is present, that it's actually the cause of the symptoms that people have got, particularly in the absence of other problems, the more classical heartburn, regurgitation symptoms. But So I think we agreed that we needed to do some further investigation. So I think we then did some more tests.
Each test gave us a little bit more information, didn't it? There was none where like 6 months previous, where nothing was proving anything. So I was quite happy to blow into a tube and stick things up my nose and droplets, not making fun of it, but because when you eventually got the results, it was guiding us all the time. And remember also, on a personal level, it was pretty upsetting because I couldn't commit to any work, which, that's okay. But what it does to your head when you can't commit to any work, and my work is what defines me. I'm a singer. I go out and play in front of people, whether it be 5 people or 5,000 people.
Just 19 when he got off the plane. Both his feet never touched the ground.
For you, the fact you couldn't sing was obviously just a major problem, wasn't it? I mean, and I think that's the point. What's really important about the impact that reflux can have on people's symptoms is incredibly individual. It's very subjective. Yeah. Everybody, it will affect differently, and it's really only them that can come to the conclusion as to how far they want to go down the road to solve those problems.
Yeah, well said. I think, since I've told my story, probably too many times to people, everybody's had reflux. Everybody knows, I know what you're going through. Cool, bit of burning. I said, well, no, not with me. That doesn't make me special, because I know other people who have serious heartburn issues. It must be hell. And then you offered me, really, towards the end, there were 3 choices, weren't there, on what where we could go.
Well, I think the repeat test that we did, whereas the first test had shown borderline evidence of reflux, but it hadn't really been positive. The Bravo test we did, which is the little capsule test, was really very positive. And I think, if you remember, we found that, I explained that very often you do need to do quite a few tests to get to the answer. But the Bravo test was really strongly positive. And it gave us, not only it demonstrated there was definite abnormally high levels of acid in the esophagus.
That's a lot.
But that some of your symptoms, your throat clearing, for instance, was strongly associated with measuring those reflux events. So I was convinced you got reflux. The question, of course, was always going to be whether that was the cause of your problems with your throat. And we talked through the pros and cons and what the likely success rates and the potential risks. And you chose to have LINX. Was there any particular reason why you chose LINX?
The LINX therapy approach was, I was inquisitive of it. It was reversible if anything didn't work, I suppose. And I'm really into new way of thinking. It seemed an attractive way. And also, the most important of it is you get a little card that says that when you go through the airport that you've got metal inside you. That was the clincher.
I can understand. So we agreed you were going to go ahead with surgery. And tell us a little bit about how that experience was like.
Shockingly, in the best way, easy and brief and painless. It sounds like you've slipped me a fiver to say this, but it was incredible. Scars, just everything perfect. The pain, it was just too good to be true, really. Of course, there was the waiting and the sitting and me bugging you by calling the office every couple of weeks, but no. Yeah.
One of the fears that people have got after all of these operations is difficulty with swallowing, which can affect people after all anti-reflux operations. I mean, was that a problem for you?
I think for the first 2 or 3 days I was careful, so I didn't push it.
Yeah.
So, but then I just almost forgot about it. Yeah, I didn't have any problem at all. Your first few days maybe more soup than, pizza, but it just became unnoticeable. And the gigs were booked for February the 4th with an orchestra. I mean, dear God, you can't be, it wasn't down the pub. It was with an orchestra at the London Palladium, one of the shows. And I walked on and, I already knew about 3 weeks before the tour, it was back. you'd met me last year, it was, I wasn't broken or anything like that. You know, I'm a very lucky man. I have a lovely life and family, but I, you know, now we're taking the bookings in, I'm planning and I'm writing, all that energy that you, that I usually give off is back. Yeah. You know, and that's a great feeling. Thank you.